Hello, in this tutorial I will show you how to use the remote control app for Nano Teleprompter. You should have two Android devices, one to use as a remote control and the other as the teleprompter device. Both devices should be connected to the same Wi-Fi network. You can connect to the router or connect the devices to each other using hotspot. Make sure that you are on the homepage on the Nano Teleprompter app, otherwise you will not be able to find the device. You should be on the homepage where all the scripts are available. When the device is found, click on it to connect. If you would like to open the devices list again, just click on the remote icon here. After connecting the devices, you can open any script in the Nano Teleprompter app using the second tab here. You can choose the mode, floating or full screen. You can write the name of the script to filter the list and click on any script to open it. Then there's the settings tab. Here you can change all the settings of the Nano Teleprompter app. Finally, we have the remote settings tab. Here you can change the scroll sensitivity for the manual scroll buttons. You can assign functions to the physical volume buttons or change the layout. Now let's start by opening the first script. I click on the script to open it. Here it is. Now let's go to the remote tab. Now in this layout, the first bar is showing you the progress of the text and also the remaining time here. You can move the thumb to scroll to a specific point in the text. Also, you can see the percentage of the progress in the thumb. The second bar is to change the speed of the scrolling. The big button in the middle is to pause and resume. The buttons below that are to scroll up and down manually. Then we have the previous and next hashtag buttons. This will help you move to a specific point faster. Now the button at the top is to import changes from Google Drive. If you change the text on your computer, you can click this button to import the changes. Now here are the settings. The same exact settings page available in Nano Teleprompter is also available in the remote. So you can change all the settings, colors, text size, orientation, highlights, margin, everything can be controlled using the remote app. We have also added special buttons for the floating window. You can change the opacity of the floating window using this bar. You can change the size of the floating window using the buttons on the right side and the position of the floating window using the buttons on the left side. You can also rotate the window by clicking on this button. Now the last screen here is to control the remote app settings. First, the scroll sensitivity. This is for the manual scrolling buttons. Now it's slow. I will pause and as you can see, it will scroll slowly while clicking on the scroll up and down buttons. We have created a big range between 10 and 150, so you will have full control on the manual scrolling speed. The next feature is the ability to assign functions to the physical volume up and down buttons on your device. Using the volume up button, I can pause, resume, scroll up and down, increase, decrease speed, move to the next or previous paragraph. Same for the volume down button. We have also created many layouts to suit everyone's need. For example, the next layout uses buttons to change the scrolling speed. The button at the top increases the speed and the button at the bottom decreases it. Some layouts are simple, like this one for example, and some of them are suited for left-hand users and some are more suited for right-hand users. We will always be adding more layouts, so if you have any suggestions, please let us know. Now after you finish and you exit the Nano Teleprompter app, the remote service will keep running. So if I exit the app here, you will notice there is a small remote control icon. I can still use the remote to control the app and open the scripts. Even if you disconnected from the remote control app, you can reconnect directly without opening the NanoTeleprompter app. Now, to close the remote service on the NanoTeleprompter device, you can click on the icon and click Stop Service or drag it down to close the service. If you close the service, you will have to open the NanoTeleprompter app again to connect. If you have any suggestions or questions, our contact information will be in the description below. Thank you very much for watching.